Carl Taylor, University of South Alabama College of Medicine, and the director of the Center for Strategic Health Innovation. The IIA gave me an opportunity to talk about broadband and outreach into rural Alabama in two perspectives, one with reference to healthcare and certainly the other in reference to disaster preparedness, both of which are key and actually connected because for almost any disaster, one of the common denominators is going to be the need for healthcare. A lot of what we've been doing is actually building a patient-centric approach to healthcare, trying to give the patient a greater say in how to be compliant, how to be part of their healthcare, not just part of their illness. The tools that we now see is this migratory path from Health 1.0, which is just the way we deliver care. Patient goes to the physician's office and goes away with a written prescription, to Health 2.0, where the patient has at least an opportunity to go online and to search for information about their illness or their condition. What we see is the next migratory shift, and that's really a shift to what I call Health 3.0. And it's that opportunity truly for the patient not just to search online for health information, but to be part of the building and construction of their own health record, to have the ability of physiologic sensors that are populating that data so that we know how the patient's doing when they're not in their physician's officer, not in the hospital. So they were able to take that data, put it into a patient-centric record, and compare that patient's care against the care of all patients with common conditions across this country to come back with very specific recommendations of personalized care so that we truly are delivering care one patient at a time, managing their outcomes. In order to do that, though, we need reach. The future of healthcare as we move from electronic health records to what I call a me health record, that information about me, is going to be highly bandwidth consumptive. My health record, the me health record, is one that's going to take data and turn it into images with high visualization. The information that we need to downstream to a patient's home about compliance, about exercise, about drug management, is going to be something that's going to be video and high definition video driven. That's again bandwidth consumptive, not just to a laptop or to a desktop, but we have to look at an mHealth delivered strategy as well. 64% of our patients have a mobile phone as their main means of communication. So when we talk about broadband, we're talking about broadband not just into the home, but wherever the patient is, at any time, anywhere, any place. You know, I think one of the interesting challenges with reference to the stimulus is that it offers us an opportunity truly to wire rural Alabama. The challenge, of course, is going to be looking for the right projects, creating the right sustainability, finding the right match and the right dollars. I believe healthcare offers that opportunity. We've done a study that very clearly shows that contrary to, I think, popular belief, that many rural patients that are managed in the absence of appropriate specialty care are actually more expensive, spend more time in the hospital, spend more time in an outpatient setting, and actually consume more medications than if there was a virtual way to deliver care to them with the same kind of specialty component that their urban counterparts can be. Those savings alone could demonstrate the ability to more than make up the match that's going to be required to build that system.